It's great for a tray whale on a spinnerbait.
This is that lily pad. It's a pretty big one.
You know, I felt the tap. I let it drop. The bass. They just keep coming.
So I feed it through the two black and yellow halves.
Hey guys, I just caught this about probably a foot and a half long, maybe. It's a black tip shark on a big 6-inch live mullet.
Hook in the Strike King Bitsy Boo jig with the net bait pack a trunk trailer.
Hey guys, welcome to this episode of Southbound Fishing. Today I'm basically going to show you how to make a simple live bait rig for freshwater or saltwater. And alright, I'll show you right now. So the materials I've got right here is I've got an egg weight, and depending on where you're fishing, what you're fishing for, and what the current is like where you're fishing at, you'll want to use a heavier or lighter size. This right here is an ounce. Just so I can chunk it pretty far with the bait rigged up on there as well, and so that it's not too heavy that it drags it down. So I've got my length of line right here. Again, depending on where you're fishing, what you're fishing for, will determine the line weight. And this is just, I think this is just 10 pound test. I'm just rigging this up just to show you guys. So I've got my tag in right here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to run it through the egg weight, bring that through the egg weight. Then right here, I've got a 12-inch leader. This is 45-pound test. This is wire, nylon-coated wire. You could buy this at a store such as Bass Pro Shops, Walmart, or you can hand-make your own, and it's got a barrel swivel and a coastlock swivel. So, now that you've got the egg weight through, what I'm going to do is I'm going to run my line in and tie whatever knot you really want to tie. I would suggest a surgeon's knot. That's what I do for all my rigs for my saltwater fishing. Just look that up if you want to know how to tie it. There's a lot of great tutorials on YouTube and online about that one. So, I'll just finish tying this up. Tied and ready to go. And then, so after I have that, now this is what my rig looks like as of right now. I have the egg weight, and then I have my leader. And then what I'm going to do is I have a 3-aught live bait circle hook from Laser Sharp, inline circle hook. So that is going to be the hook that goes through the nose of the bait. So I put that on right there. That's easy enough. And then what I also have is I have a snell. I have a 6-inch snell, and this is 45-pound test mono. And then a 1-aught bait holder hook, also by Laser Sharp, pre-made snell. And if you're going for fish such as shark, redfish, bigger fish, that really, they don't just bite and spook off. They'll bite and then they'll bite more and bite more. Aggressive fish, then you would want just a normal hook through the nose or hook through the tail rig. But if you're going for bluefish, those kind of fish, Spanish mackerel, sea trout, those fish often bite off the tail of the bait if you have no stinger hook. So what I'll do is I'll take the loop of the snelled hook rig, and I'll put that right through the swivel as well, and then I'll close it up. And then when I have my bait rigged, and you know, it doesn't have to be a 6-inch, it can be a 2-inch if you're using a live shrimp. It could be a 10-inch if you're using a massive hog leg mullet. It just depends on your bait, along with the size of the leader, the weight, and the hooks. It all depends on what your bait is. Now I'm rigging this for a finger mullet to, you know, not the smallest mullet, the medium-sized to larger-sized mullet. And I'm rigging this for an all-purpose rig, so I'm going to have the stinger hook on there. And I'm also going to be tossing it in light to no current, so I have not the heaviest weight on there, just an ounce. But I also have a nice long leader, because you don't know what's out there. So, to hook a bait on this, what I'll do is I'll take the mullet, and I'll grab it by the head, and then I'll hook it right through the eyes. Hook it sideways through the bottom portion of the eyes on the circle hook, and then I will just barely tuck this in on the tail. Not, you don't want it totally impale the bait because that might sever the spine. You just want to barely tuck it into the tail, and you don't want to take it onto the muscles of the tail, the fin, or any of that. You just want to tuck it right in there, right on the scales, and that'll keep your bait moving free, and it'll keep it alive the longest. And there you go. You've got an easy saltwater live bait rig. And another couple more modifications you could do this rig is you don't need this stinger hook right here if you're going for shark or something like that. And you also don't need the weight. If you're just throwing it into a total feeding frenzy of stripers or bluefish, you can just skip the whole weight altogether. And that's about it. Also, another thing is if you're using a cork rig and it just has that snap, you can use the same setup for a live mullet. And you'll catch more fish instead of pulling in a half chomped off bait. So there you go. Thanks for watching this episode of Southbound Fishing. Comment, like, and subscribe. Thanks, guys.